My name is Alexander Wyatt. I'm a genomic scientist working in Vancouver at University of British Columbia. I've got an involvement in the Correlative Sciences Committee and also in the Trial Design Committee for Genitourinary Cancers. So the IND 223 and 234 trials are important because in prostate cancer, particularly late stage prostate cancer, the cancers can be very aggressive, but they're also very heterogeneous. So the standard therapies that we use are only effective in a proportion of patients, and there's some patients that don't respond at all. And that only gets worse as you move down the line. So when we think about how to introduce new therapies into prostate cancer, if we sort of use these therapies indiscriminately across a whole population, they're likely to fail because we'll see low response rates. But if we can instead enrich the population in which we'll test these drugs, potentially by finding certain molecular subtypes that are likely to sensitize a tumor to treatment, we can find a way to get these drugs to patients and therefore show efficacy in subsets. So it's about trying to find a strategy that we can get targeted agents into prostate cancer without them failing through a large population testing. So we're seeing from sort of the cutting edge research at the moment that tumor biomarkers can actually help understand which patients are likely to respond or not. But if we want to prove that and we want to really make that able to be sort of implemented on a wide scale, we have to prove it within the framework of a dedicated clinical trial. And so that's where I think the next important trials to be run in prostate cancer. We need to understand why, and we need to think about in those patients where there isn't a response, can we elicit one through combination therapy? Can we understand the extreme responders, the patients that respond really, really well? It's sort of about understanding the patient, because then the next time a patient comes along, one's sort of better equipped to treat them appropriately. Collaborative clinical research is many fold, but it's mostly about leveraging expertise. You can't be good at everything. I'm a genomicist, a bioinformatician, and I can learn second languages in the sense of medical oncology or urology, but I'm never going to be an expert in them, so I'm reliant on sort of leveraging other people's expertise. So it's critical to have experts at all levels at the table. But also from the point of view of patient diversity, if you limit your impression of patients to a small population within a single province, it's probably not representative of the whole of Canada. So again, collaborative research on a Canada-wide scale allows you to sample that diversity and make sure that you haven't missed things that might be present at a large population level.